Acetaminophen is one of the popular medication, also known as paracetamol. This medication is used as analgesic as well as antipyretic. However, it is not having anti-inflammatory actions. Acetaminophen is well known with its brand Tylenol, but nowadays a number of generic versions are available. This acetaminophen is one of the widely used medication to treat fever as antipyretic. It can also be used for management of headache as well as mild body pains. This acetaminophen is available as tablets at a strength of 250 mg, 500 mg and 650 mg. It is also available at a strength of 1000 mg as a once-a-day preparation. Among many medications, acetaminophen tablets are widely used. It is also available as a suspension for pediatric purpose at a strength of 125 mg to 250 mg per 5 ml. Then what is the effect of this acetaminophen on the liver? Acetaminophen can induce the acute liver failure in many of the people, and it is one of the major reasons for development of liver toxicity in many people. However, this liver toxicity is not observed at normal dose. A toxic dose of acetaminophen can induce liver toxicity. Then what is the normal dosage? The normal dose of acetaminophen in the adults is variable from 500 to 650 mg for each dose given every 4 hours in a day. Generally, acetaminophen can be given 4 times a day, so the maximum dose is less than 3 grams per day. However, this liver toxicity can be observed at a dose above 4 grams per day. This dose is called toxic dose. Generally, acetaminophen is given 4 times a day, so the normal dose is very less compared with this toxic dose. Then how this overdose is possible? So the main reason for this overdose is sometimes intentional overdosing, but in many of the cases, unintentional overdose is possible due to lack of proper monitoring on administration of acetaminophen. One of the main reasons for overdose of acetaminophen is that this medication is available in multiple dosage forms. Acetaminophen is used as analgesic as well as antipyretic. So it can be used for this purpose in many of the formulations, and even it can be combined with few of the medications intended for treating cold. Therefore, patients may take the two medications intended for two different purposes, but still they are containing acetaminophen. This may lead to intake of increased dose per day, leading to liver toxicity. Acetaminophen can be used to treat the pain, but for treating the pain, few of the other analgesics like N-acetyls can be used. The N-acetyls are the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like diclofen, mefenamic acid, and so many drugs. Along with these drugs, acetaminophen can be combined with the same tablet, which may increase the risk of overdosing when these tablets are taken along with acetaminophen tablets. Similarly, if you have the antihistamines like phenylephrine, chlorpheniramine are used to control the symptoms of allergy and rhinitis. They are widely used in cough syrups. In such preparations, acetaminophen can be used at a low dose such as 325 mg. If these preparations are taken repeatedly along with acetaminophen tablets, again it may lead to development of toxicity. Similarly, acetaminophen is also available in the OTC drugs, over-the-counter drugs, for treatment of headaches and mild body pains. Therefore, it is highly essential to check the content of acetaminophen in the multi-dosage forms, because in many of the formulations, acetaminophen is going to be involved. Simultaneous taking of these preparations may increase acetaminophen toxicity. Effect of alcohol. Acetaminophen is going to be metabolized by cytochrome P450 system into its toxic metabolite NAPQI. This metabolism is carried by one of the specific enzymes CYP2E1. But when alcohol is co-administered with acetaminophen, what happens? Alcohol is also metabolized by cytochrome P450 system. Therefore, there will be a competition between alcohol and acetaminophen for this metabolic enzyme. This may reduce the liver toxicity produced by acetaminophen when it is taken along with alcohol. However, in people with chronic alcoholism, the alcohol can further increase the liver damage produced by acetaminophen. Taking acetaminophen along with opioids. Generally, acetaminophen acts as a mild analgesic, but in people who require a potent analgesic effect, opioids can be combined. Opioids like oxycodone can be combined with acetaminophen. These combinations can be used to control the pain produced in few of the people. However, this combination may also lead to the risk of overdoses with acetaminophen. Because opioids can delay gastric emptying, the acetaminophen may be more present in the stomach. That may increase the absorption. And taking along with opioids, the net dose of acetaminophen may also be increased, resulting in overdoses. That's why the dose of acetaminophen is limited to 325 mg when it is combined with opioids. What happens on toxic dose of acetaminophen? A toxic dose of acetaminophen can develop acute symptoms within 24 hours. The extent of overdose depends on which type of other medications that are co-administered. Initially, the patients may have abdominal discomfort, nausea and vomiting, and a state of fatigue can be observed with lack of energy. Excessive sweating can also be observed, and liver enzymes are going to be elevated after 18 hours. But in few people, the liver enzymes can also be elevated after 8 hours. Particularly, the liver enzymes like aspartate transaminase AST as well as alanine transaminase ALT are going to be elevated, which indicates liver injury. After 24 hours of toxic dose, symptoms of jaundice are going to be developed, leading to yellowish discoloration of the skin and eyes. And hepatomegaly is also developed, leading to pain in the upper right quadrant. Liver injury starts after 72 hours of toxicity, and acid levels are elevated, leading to lactic acidosis. This indicates improper oxidation and development of anaerobic conditions. If it is untreated, it may also lead to kidney failure, which further impairs lactic acidosis. Finally, it may lead to multi-organ failure, affecting many of the organs in the body. Therefore, it is highly essential to treat the liver toxicity produced by acetaminophen as early as possible. Now, let us see the mechanism of liver toxicity produced by acetaminophen. The main route of clearance of acetaminophen from the body is through the conjugation. It is going to be converted into conjugates by two processes, glucuronidation as well as sulfonation. 90% of the administered acetaminophen undergoes conjugation and it is going to be excreted in the urine. However, a small amount of acetaminophen can also be directly excreted in the urine as unchanged. Another route of clearance is the metabolism by cytochrome P450 system. Acetaminophen can be converted into one of its metabolites, NAPQI, N-acetyl para-benzoquinone-imine. This metabolism is carried by one of the cytochrome P450 enzymes, CYP2E1. Less than 10% of acetaminophen is converted into these metabolites. So these are the various processes by which acetaminophen is going to be cleared from our body. However, in case of overdose, this acetaminophen is more metabolized into NAPQI. This metabolite is a toxic metabolite which can produce the liver damage. Under normal dose, this toxic metabolite is going to be converted into non-toxic metabolite by action of glutathione. But in case of overdose, the glutathione levels are depleted, resulting in the increased accumulation of this toxic metabolite that results in oxidative stress. With overdose of acetaminophen, the metabolic pathway is more elevated, leading to oxidative stress. This oxidative stress can release few of the free radicals that can produce damage to liver. How it is treated? One of the main aim in treating acetaminophen toxicity is to reduce the liver damage. This can be achieved as early as possible after the administration of toxic dose. When it is possible, the absorption of acetaminophen should be reduced within 1 hour of overdosing. The absorption of acetaminophen can be reduced by many methods. One of the approaches is to administer activated charcoal. This activated charcoal can reduce the absorption by formation of complex with acetaminophen. However, this approach is suitable for the people who are conscious and are able to respirate properly. Within early hours of overdosing, emetics can also be used to stimulate the emesis and expulsion of excess dose of acetaminophen. But after several hours, this use of emetics is ineffective. Another approach to treat acetaminophen toxicity is the administration of an antidote. N-acetyl cysteine acts as an antidote for acetaminophen, which is one of the prodrug, and it acts as a glutathione precursor. This antidote acts as a supplier of cysteine, which increases the conjugation of this toxic metabolite with thiol groups, resulting in the decreased NAPQI accumulation. Therefore, this antidote can detoxify the NAPQI and it increases the conjugation. It also reverses the metabolic process, thereby it can increase the conjugation of acetaminophen. This reduces oxidative damage and improves hepatic function. In this way, acetaminophen toxicity can be treated by administration of N-acetyl cysteine. So that's all about acetaminophen-induced liver toxicity. I hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.